This is through. Who is it by? Who is it by? It's by Pitofo 789. Let me just pause the game. We're on three country corner, and we're on the OEBB 4023. Right, I need to put power on, lights on. Has power come on yet? Looks like it. PZB. Key. Turn the key on. Pantograph up. Get the doors open. Main switch. I can't remember how you turn Cipher on. I thought it was one of these. It is that one. Ah, there you go. And we got Cipher. Evan Goodnight, thank you for the subscription. Very much. Appreciate your support, Evan Goodnight. Right, that's done. So close the doors. Doors are closed. Release the spring brake. Now, assuming we got power. Oh, look at this. First time, folks. Except with. It's better. So I can see the. I need to see this because it's not showing up on the little HUD. Oh no, Cipher didn't work. Right, let's try that again. Right, green, yellow, 30 limits. Yeah, good old Cipher. That's one way of putting it. Still in 40 limit at the moment. We're out of monitoring. Green, green on the semaphore. Wow, I really enjoy driving this train. It's so much fun. Hello. That's not going to be the right way of doing it. Alright, coming up on a 90. No monitoring or anything, so speeding up. It's Luckau next, 5.4 kilometres. Trying to keep a really close eye on the Cipher light because I think my audio is starting to lag a bit. Which means that the warning I get on Cipher will be less than I need. Quite understand that signal, so I'm just acknowledging it, and I didn't need to, which is good. Means it's green green. Apologies, I'm not looking at the chat at the moment. Right, coming up to 100. Green, green again. Wow, this schedule is tight. I'm nailing it as close as I can to 100 and I'm not gaining any time back. Moggy being mean to me? What's Moggy saying? I'm bad, old and slow. Boy! The other thing you've got to remember with this is you can't just smack the key, you've actually got to press it firmly, hold it, and then release it. Alright, got green vor signal. Mog doesn't have any reason to get up, is to be after me. He's just, that's who he is. He's just decided it's Matt's turn to be on the wrong side of his wrath. Right, slowing down. Acknowledged. Oh, hello. Oh, I was going too fast as I hit there. I was going too fast, I guess, as I went through that. Not quite sure why. Another one of those rules that I haven't remembered. Right, let's reinitialize PZB. Bang went getting in there remotely on time. It almost blew the restricted monitoring. Ambassador 30, thank you for the follow, sir. Much appreciated. Does this happen in real life? Yeah, if the drivers drive like I do, then this happens in real life. PZB is life. Sacked drivers in. Open doors on that side, and then press T. Yeah, I need to remind myself what I did wrong on that one, because that was a green-yellow, expect reduction to 40. Maybe I needed to be going below 75 before I even got to it. I'm not sure. I've got a green light up ahead, so I'm going to release from monitoring. Right, away we go. Released from monitoring, 100 kph. But no German experts who can tell me what I did wrong. Yeah, I acknowledged the signal, it almost immediately put the brakes on. Start easing down for 60. Good morning, Trackmaster Torres. Well, I have got a cab what'll do for this. So double yellows expect a 40 at the next signal, remember rightly. Double yellow green. Yep, that's the expect reduction advance warning. God, I'm waiting well late now. Get paranoid about this now. That's an expect 60 at the next signal, 40 at this one. There it goes again. I have no idea why that is, but I'm going to open the doors anyway. I have no idea why that tripped. None at all. Oh, come on. Off we go. Right, restriction to 40 kmh because of restriction and because of PZB and speed limit. Does three country corner even have a proper PZB? I don't know, I thought it did. But I'm prepared to be told I'm wrong. Certainly not aware of what I'm doing wrong. But the thing is, there are sometimes sort of little obscure rules that I'm not aware of or forgetting, and those are the ones that are normally get trapping me. Right, Bludenz. Bludenz. Open the doors on the left. Bridge end. Nice view. Still in restricted monitoring, so I see a positive signal at 40 kph. Double green, I think, is 60 kilometers an hour, remember rightly. Right, restrict from that. Oh, it's it shut the wipers off there automatically. Did you see that, folks? Isn't that awesome? Right, 120. Somewhere we're there, we had a brief section drop to 60. I don't know where that came from. How long is this scenario? This is 70 minutes in total. Totally missed that. But the thing is, when it's accelerating, the CIFA sound just completely drowned out. Or at least it is for my... I'm deaf. Part deaf, so... Try that again. Ah, you know, you just come here to shout fail all the time. Right, piece of BAC didn't go on that time. Bludenz Rydenburg is next. Whose idea was it to turn CIFA on, anyway? That was a silly idea. Right, coming into Bludenz. Thought my ears are okay now, they are okay. I've always been a bit deaf. Now I'm just back to my normal deafness. Which essentially means I find it very hard to hear high-pitched sounds. What's the list anyway? Oh, I've got all these we're late for. Going all the way to Bludenz down there. So we've got a few stops to do yet. Off we go. Perhaps if you open the doors on the wrong side. I don't know. I imagine the passengers don't really like it. Katie, due to work in the you got no top end due to being in the music industry. I have no such excuse, unfortunately. I used to just have my stereo on too loud. Archangel UK, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Kilometers to Dornburn. Is the TS website down? Oops. Right. Apologies if you're in the chat and I'm not paying attention to you. Every time I pay attention to the chat, I miss a C4 or something. Hashtag blame chat. I blame chat because it's true. Not stopping here. We're actually managing to pull some time together back now. Not a lot. We're back down to a minute late, folks. Four kilometres. All right, speed dropped coming up to 120. About 40 seconds late now. It's been a small window of opportunity here to gain some time back. Until the next time I fluff PZB. There you go, just went straight away. I've got no idea why that went off. I acknowledged it. I'm not calling it fail. Something's wrong here. Something's got to be wrong. Or there's extra rules that I'm not aware of. That could be it. Every PZB at the moment is causing a brakes to go on. Turn PZB off. Yeah, you might be right. I don't like the term vis-a-vis off, it's just wrong. Oh no, that one was mine. That one was mine, because I just accelerated and I accelerated over 45 km/h and come on. Come on! But not over 40 this time. I know you're in a rush. It wouldn't be so bad if I knew why. At least the newer dovetail locos actually pop up in the top right corner why it shut you down, so that you can learn from it. My problem with like this is, yes, it's realistic, but I can't learn from it because I don't know what I did wrong. Right, single yellow. Acknowledged. Thing is, I've got a feeling I remember Jan telling me what I'd done wrong, and I'm sure I'm missing a rule. I'm sure I'm missing a rule or something. But I can't remember what it was. No, it's the PZB that's been jumping me out. It's because of the way the speed's behaving. Where I'm driving the train. And I think I'm within the rules, but I'm clearly not. Or there's a bug. See you later, Exeter. Right, open the door. Do that. Hey, train sim fan. I mentioned at the beginning of the stream, folks. Don't forget that. Don't forget November 18th, 24-hour stream. I've started getting some prizes together, so I've got 100 bits of DLC from Dovetail up for grabs, 16 bits from A2A Simulations, big thanks to A2A and Dovetail. Oh, I should probably shut the doors, shouldn't I? It'll be any bit of current DLC, Peachlick. No, about staying under the braking curve. Well, yeah, I mean, I know that when you go through a PZB. Oh, hello. Don't do it. I nearly did it. When you go through a warning, you have to drop down to 85 on this one, and then you've got an amount of time to get down to 85 if you're not already, but I've been up below 85 before the alarm, and then you need to be down to 45 by the 500 hertz magnet if one is on, because you're approaching a red. Now, we've not approached any red, so those haven't been the problem, so I can only assume it's been what I have to, I've either hit the 1000 hertz too hard, too fast, or I'm doing something else wrong. I'm driving this pretty much the way I've driven the other German scenarios, so... We're out of restricted monitoring now, so I can gun it. I really enjoy PZB. As frustrating as it is at times like this, I think PZB is one of the things that makes this game really fun for me, because when you get it right, it's supremely rewarding. I've got this horrible suspicion that this train is not supposed to be going at this kind of speed. I'm supposed to be going 85 or less, or something dark like that. I haven't got in touch with all the third-party developers yet. I'm going to start firing off emails to Justin, Armstrong, Steam Sound Supreme, and see what I can arrange. Greens. Next station is Honems. Which we're due in right now. I'm taking it easy on the speed now, because I've got this sneaky suspicion the problem is I'm actually going too fast. Crazy Dan, so during the 24-hour stream, there'll be 100 bits of DLC given out. I don't know how many giveaways that'll end up being. Maybe 20. 24. Don't really do the giveaways on a fixed schedule, just probably usually between each scenario. Twitcher for life, can I write you a note? I know the train can do 140 km/h, but if I hit these PZBs doing 140 km/h, or even, I think, over 85, they're all triggering the brakes. And normally you can go over 1,000 Hz on PZB-O at 160 km/h, so it shouldn't be causing a problem. Try to place the giveaways better. What was wrong with them? I thought they went alright, actually. I guess we did end up with a bit of stuff at the end, but that's commonly the problem, because I don't want to run out early on, so we generally sort of reasonable pace it out as we go, and then we get to the end and it's just, right, got all of these to give away, let's do 20 giveaways. More green. Start time on the 18th is 1 p.m. UK time. You thought it was too much stuff given away at the start? No, we ended up with stuff to give away at the end. Yeah, if anything, we ended up with... large amounts of stuff. I went through the sheet from the cancer stream and cancer research stream, and it was very much loaded towards the end. Right, says Honams. Now 3.5 minutes late. Yeah, I was a bit late getting started. Hey Morbs, I'm glad you're here. You can tell me what I'm doing wrong. You think I need to press it as I go over it? Alright, I'll try that actually. That's a good shout. I'll try that. I'm used to the dovetail ones where you have to press it after you go through. I will try that. I will try that. Right. We've still got plenty of time in this scenario. Just realised I didn't actually open the doors. I just told the game to open the doors. Didn't unlock them. Green. No monitoring. Push it to 140. See you later, Jenny. Right. Can we go in 3 minutes? Doesn't say it's maximum speed? No, it doesn't. Gutsis. Gutsis. Rubku, welcome to the stream. Welcome to Rubku's viewers. Dutch raid hype. And Coploppermau's bringing the Frankers. As always. Coming in, Gutsis. That's okay, I've got this. It's your duty to bring the Frankers. Indeed, that's what we keep you around for, Corporal, really. We're on Three Country Corner at the moment, Corporal Pamau. Thordnik, that was really close to the correct Gutsis. Excellent! I will eventually get some of these names right. I'm not going to promise that. Right, let's open the door this time. Love the sounds on this. For an electric locos, quite often it's difficult to get the right sounds for them, but they seem to have nailed this one. It's really nice. Brakes off. Off we go. Accelerate to 160. We've got no monitoring or anything on. Green light at the end of the platform. Well, no, most of the brakes on this are actually done with the e-brakes rather than the air brakes. Did DTG do work experience? Sometimes. Your best off is to go to the Dovetail website and send a message there to the HR people. Oh yeah, I'm only going up to 140. It is Rubku's birthday tomorrow, is it? Well, happy birthday for tomorrow, Rubku. I'm not turning the wipers off. In fact, they turn themselves off. Check it out! This train has got Moggy approved wipers built in as standard. You know, we've almost brought it back to a minute and a half late. What I need now is a nice PZB heater. Throw it all back again. GWR, does it work without the tunnels on the HUD? I imagine it doesn't, because they're all sort of... Without the tunnels showing up on the HUD, I imagine that the internal query would not know. PZB down. That's it. Brakes are on. So it acknowledged it and then slammed the brakes on anyway. Someone tell me what's going wrong. Please, someone tell me what's going wrong. Yeah, it will shout fail, but if someone could tell me why it was failing, that would be great. PZB has gone completely now. Oh, that's better. Alright, rear brakes are coming off. I was already braking. At least I remember the restrictive monitoring this time. Yeah, I think we'll isolate PZB. Airline dynamite. CSX SD40 is stopping at over 20 miles an hour because it's got in-cab signalling on. Turn it off. If you're not using in-cab signalling, turn it off. Control D, Control F will turn them off. Let's open the doors and we will isolate PZB. I am broken or it's broken, one of the two. Daniel Codrington, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Hey Oblivious. DJSB, yes, I got your message, thank you. Right. 140, 60. Yeah, it's double green, so it's 60. No, what I'll do is I'll send this over to Jan Chudoba and get him to walk through, and he'll tell me what I did wrong in great detail, which is always really useful. I suspect it is that I'm going too fast, but I can't work out what I should be doing. Alright, slowing down to 40 for the next signal. GWR, yeah, anything about the TSCOM website, definitely talk to Steve about. I don't know what's happening with that website, I don't run it. Steve can tell you what's happening on that. Right, 40 at this point. Well, somewhere beyond this signal anyway. Well, something's not right there. We passed a green-yellow signal and it stayed at 140. No, you can't pass. Well, you can kind of pass some reds, yes, but the flashing reds you can pass, but solid reds you can't. But if you've got like green red on American signals, that's a red. That's not a red, it's a green. All right, what's this? 60 through here. Well, that's not updating it at all. The speed still says 110. I don't know what's going on anymore. Feldkirch. I love this route. It's a pretty, pretty route. Oh, the 60 just started. Right, let's go past 3B into 3A. Do I feel okay, Flams? I feel absolutely fine. I could do with another cup of tea, and I'm going to fix that after this scenario. I kind of wish I knew what was going on with this scenario, because I like driving PZB and I like driving this train. And I've obviously forgotten something. Take a screenshot while we're here. We're off, 110 limit, coming into a 90. All of a sudden we're down to 60. Now we're back up to 90. It's just random, isn't it? You get a nice view of the CIFA light in the tunnel. Not such a great light view of the throttle handle though. Yeah, with the new hydrogen trains, will they be able to make tea from the exhaust? Absolutely. That seems like a worthwhile use of hydrogen trains. There's Frostans. Get about 56 FPS at the moment, which isn't bad. The scenario doesn't know what it wants, no. DeChaz, have you tried looking at my scenario? I've got some tutorials on how to create your own scenario. It's on my YouTube channel. Tells you basically what you need to get started. It's not a lot to it, to be perfectly honest. It's a relatively straightforward process. Look a bit stressed. No, I'm fine. You're the second person to ask, I'm alright. Kind of wish that this was going a bit better, but never mind. Tea will be drunk, and after the stream, Toblerone will be consumed. Whoops. Oh, it didn't need to stop. Excellent. Yeah, I mean, even Steven Channel can write them, so. Hey, Cowspec, welcome. K Calspec subbed silly o'clock this morning, if I remember rightly. So thank you for subbing, Calspec. What about the station, Flames? Loads of time to stop at the station. Given the trucks, what's my job at Dovetail? I'm a senior producer for Train Sim World, so essentially I look after the team that are producing the new train simulator. As well as doing some designs on it, tests on it, sort of all round. General, I do what I can to help the team, essentially. Right, 140, and we are off for Nensing. Five kilometers for Nensing. That was cool. How are we doing now on the end, anyway? Oh, we're Nensing, then Bludenz. Track Mr. Torres, you just have your dream job and come home and play Train Sim. Yep, absolutely. Hey, we're going to be ahead of time into Nensing. How's that happened? No, I don't do any route building or coding. Well, I say that. I have dabbled a little bit in the coding side of it, but... No, I don't. We've got people who are so good at the route building, it's just anything I can do would just be utterly embarrassing. So I provide my insights and my thoughts and my input. And then I'm told where to put it. No, I'm really focusing at the moment on things like the gameplay side of things. Controls and all that stuff. Alright, coming up to Nensing. Good night, Ninja Joker! You know I can't answer that, Coplop ML. Yeah, you can mention trains, of course you can. Oh dear. Did we arrive on time? Philly X Gaming! Thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Open the shut doors. Right, 140 up for Bludenz in 10 kilometers. Can you mention Southern Bell and Evening Star? Yeah, you could do Moggy if you want to. I'm crazy, Dan. I can't answer that, I'm afraid. Can you mention kebabs, Lewis Bloom? You can mention kebabs, as long as you're supplying. Little Jim Glass, you just upgraded to the Pioneers Edition. Superb. JBR, can you mention the best loco in the world? You can indeed talk about Pacers. External shots on the on this one are tricky due to the presence of Seif. There you go. Seif just got me. That's why I don't do external shots. Oh, it's just released the brakes. I can get going again. Hey, we don't have to stop. So I get outside immediately, see if it goes off. Four point 7 kilometers. It's linked to the external view, yeah, I know. That's I'm sure of that as well, to be honest. We're still looking to be a few seconds early. A minute early, actually. Are you still snacking, Strat Shadow? Alright, reduce for 60 at the next signal. Out in Loveridge, I don't run anything that's not Steam. There are various reasons for it. But no, if it's not on Steam, I don't. If, like, the AP I show, and the 90 I show, if they're on Steam, then I show them. You're eating bacon and red sauce flavour crisps, Ayrton. Did you get them off of the reject pile? No one will want to eat these crisps. Yeah, the speed should have dropped there. We've got double green. We should have been down at a 60 limit by now. Presume we're crossing over. I've only ever had a kebab once in my life. And I seem to remember quite enjoying it. I've just never had one again. I don't know why. I think the only reason I had the kebab the other time is because someone else bought it for me. Right, that's it. We're coming into Bludenz, which is the final station. I'm definitely going to talk to Jan and see if I can get some advice on what I was doing wrong in this scenario. There's me going to the end of the platform, and we're actually at the end of the platform. That's the other platform there. That's track C or something. Never mind. Oh, shut up, Sifa. We've stopped now. Stop getting all excitable. Ever had an Indian or a Chinese? Yeah, I've had lots of them. We seem to be living off Indian and Chinese during Tuesdays and Thursdays at work at the moment. Which I'm not complaining about, by the way. I can eat Chinese every night of the week, just about. Oh, harsh, David. Harsh. You had Chinese tonight, did you, Katie? We had quesadillas. TSW powered by Just Eat. Pretty much exactly as it happens, Lewis. Pretty much exactly. What can I say? It's easy. Yeah, we've got Chinese buffet just down the road from the office. Well, I have to say, I enjoyed the scenario. Kind of wish that I knew what was going on with the PZB so I could get more out of it, but it's a lovely loco to drive, lovely train to drive, and I really like that route because I don't really drive that route very much. Right, okay, changing route, and we're going to go for Delray Rocks.